She wanted to go back to the Justice Department. A top-flight prosecutor.
All right, everybody, again, good morning. Thank you so much for watching News Now from Fox. Pilar Arias here, joined by one of our favorites on News Now from Fox. It's Fox 5 DC's Bob Barnard. Bob, good morning. You are right outside the Capitol. What's it like out there right now?
Good morning, Pilar. Thank you very much for having us back. It's quiet, except there is a great deal of police presence here this morning, more so than we've seen at all this week. Kind of want to show you what's going on here. We have police from, this is United States Capitol Police. Obviously, they're the main ones in charge here around the Capitol complex. D.C. police have jurisdiction all around this. They are here in force, as are Virginia State Police. Most of the cars you see parked down here along the streets in front of, and you see this says State Police, that's Virginia State Police. There are also National Guard troops all around the area here. You kind of wonder, where were they on Wednesday leading up to what happened at the Capitol on Wednesday afternoon after the Trump rally down by the White House? The Capitol Police Chief, Stephen Sund, has resigned. He announced last night that he will leave on January 16th, just 4 days before the inauguration, the next big event that's scheduled or anticipated here in Washington. Sund called his officers who handled the riotous protesters who invaded the Capitol Wednesday. He called his officers valiant and heroic, but said that the Capitol Police, according to Capitol Police officials, were only prepared for a rally. They were not expecting any of the Trump supporters to try to storm the building, and that's why they were outnumbered. Chief Sund has resigned. He's a 30-year law enforcement veteran here in Washington, spent most of his career with the D.C. Police Department, the Metropolitan Police Department, and then came over here as chief in the last number of years. And basically, he's saying that they just weren't prepared for what hit them. However, there are reports now that the Pentagon offered up National Guard troops in the days leading up to Wednesday's planned rally and march, and that the Capitol Police officials declined the request. There's also reports that in the minutes after some of the Trump supporters got into the building, the FBI offered up its kind of emergency response team. And at that point, initially, for whatever reason, Capitol Police officials politely said, no, we're fine. And obviously they weren't. Also this morning, the House Sergeant at Arms, Paul Irving, and the Senate Sergeant at Arms, Michael Stenger, are also resigning. They, along with the architect of the Capitol, are the three kind of civilian officials that oversee the Capitol Police Department. This after calls from members of Congress for investigations and heads to roll. And also we'll tell you that a 12-year veteran, 42-year-old Capitol Police officer has died, the fifth person to die in the melee and chaos of Wednesday. This is an officer who was injured, apparently went back to his office and collapsed. We had heard yesterday that one Capitol Police officer had indeed had a heart attack, and that 42-year-old officer has since died. So a lot of fallout, a lot of questions still to be answered, and calls for investigations as well as those heads to roll in the wake of what happened here this week, Pilar.
Bob, you and I actually spoke Wednesday morning. You were there at the preps for the President Trump rally. I have been to a President Trump rally. When you're talking about people expecting, preparing, did you have any sentiment, any feeling, idea that what transpired on Wednesday was going to happen?
Well, you know, in the crowd, and when we spoke to you on Wednesday morning, I think it was like 7:15 in the morning, it was still a few hours before the president spoke. And not only the president, but Rudy Giuliani encouraged the people that were there to march to the Capitol and you know, fight for your votes or what have you. While we were there, the majority of the people were just fine. They were like ordinary Americans who'd come from near and far to be there supporting their president. Even before dawn that morning, though, there were some in the crowd who were screaming at us, you know, using profanity, telling us to get out of here. You know, my thought was, look, I live and work here. You're probably from out of town. Why are you telling me to get out of here? We're just on the public street covering the lead up to the Trump rally. So we felt that there were obviously some angry people in the crowd, some agitators. And if you were paying any attention, as you would think that the officials at least in charge of protecting institutions around Washington would be if you were paying attention to some of the online chatter in these pro-Trump, right-wing type, far right-wing type social media sites. There was definitely a call for arms. Bring your firearms. We're taking over the Capitol. So it was there. But while we were talking to you on Wednesday morning, you didn't feel it. But they should have known it, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Again, Fox 5's Bob Barnard out there. Thank you so much, your whole team, for the coverage this week. And stay safe out there.
Thank you, Pilar. Our pleasure. Thank you.
All right, everyone, we're taking a live look now at Times Square in New York City. Things are a little quiet this Friday morning, even though we heard in the business briefs that people were getting back to work. So we'll keep a very close eye on these live pictures across the country that we have for you. I don't